Good Sunday morning to all of you, and welcome to De La Salle Institute on this second Sunday of Lent, as we gather together this morning to grow together in the Spirit of God, be welcomed by the Spirit of God, and to embrace the Spirit of God in our midst. We gather together on this Sunday of Lent. Let us remember that we come together in the holy presence of God. So we pray together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and fellowship of the Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the season of Lent, we take some time for renewal, interior renewal, to allow the Spirit of God into our hearts, into our lives, transforming us, changing us into the love and mercy of God in this life. And so we pray. Lord Jesus, you pave the way and lead us from death to new and everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you invite us to the table of plenty to reveal your very self to us. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And Lord Jesus, you continue to invoke the Spirit, God's Spirit in our lives, leading us to be people of peace and justice, hope and healing in your world. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you have commanded us to listen to your beloved Son. Be pleased, we pray, to nourish us inwardly by your word, that with spiritual sight made pure, we may rejoice to behold your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Proclaiming our readings for us this Sunday morning is Alex Acevedo. She is a member of our senior class. She is a member of the National Honor Society, and as well as the president of the Women in STEM here at De La Salle Institute. So Alex will lead and guide us in the Word of God today.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God put Abraham to the test. He called to him, "Abraham, here I am," he replied. Then God said, "Take your son Isaac, your only one, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah. There you shall offer him up as a holocaust on a height that I will point out to you." When he came to the place of which God had told him, Abraham built an altar there and arranged the wood on it. Then he reached out and took the knife to slaughter his son. But the Lord's messenger called to him from heaven, "Abraham, Abraham." "Here I am," he answered. "Do not lay your hand on the boy," said the messenger. "Do not do the least thing to him. I know now how devoted you are to God, since you did not withhold me from your own beloved son." As Abraham looked around, he spied a ram caught by its horns in the thicket. So he went and took the ram and offered it up as a holocaust in place of his son. Again, the Lord's messenger called to Abraham from heaven and said, "I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you acted as you did, and not withholding me from your beloved son, I will bless you abundantly and make your descendants as countless as the stars of the sky and of the sands of the seashore. Your descendants shall take possession of the gates of their enemies, and in your descendants all the nations of earth shall find blessings. And this because you obeyed my command," the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, if God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all, how will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? If God who acquits us, who will condemn? Christ Jesus, it is who died, or rather, who raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus took Peter, James, and John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. And he was transfigured before them. And his clothes became dazzling white, such as no fuller on earth could bleach them. Then Elijah appeared to them along with Moses. And they were conversing with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, "Rabbi, it's good for us to be here. Let us make three tents, one for you and one for Moses, one for Elijah." He hardly knew what to say. They were so terrified. Then a cloud came, casting a shadow over them, from the cloud came a voice. "This is my beloved son. Listen to him." Suddenly, looking around, they no longer saw anyone, but Jesus alone with them. As they were coming down from the mountain, he charged them not to relate what they had seen to anyone, except when the Son of Man had risen from the dead. So they kept the matter to themselves, questioning what rising from the dead meant. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In preparation for today's celebration, I was asking one of our seniors, tell me about your year. Tell me about what happened this year, and tell me about how you feel about all of that. And as she was recounting to me what happened during the course of this year for her, she said, "I lost so much." She said, "We lost the end of our year last year because it's a year that we're into this pandemic." And she's absolutely right. We've lost so much. While her senior year isn't what she anticipated it to be because of COVID and the hybrid model of learning that we're in and seeing some friends and not seeing other friends, and recognizing that all of these end of the year activities that they normally gear up and have so much fun with are in jeopardy, or in transition more likely, that it might not be the same as it's always been. There's a sense of loss and a sense of letting go and a sense of emptiness. As the country sat by this week and recognized that we have lost 500,000 lives to this pandemic, what my senior is feeling isn't any different than any of you are feeling at home, who have lost loved ones and friends and family members, co-workers, neighbors. We're all feeling that letting go. And so what does the good news tell us? What does the good news bring to us? How do we transform our lives from loss to healing? How do we allow God to enter in and guide us forward in this moment of time through the midst of our journey of life? We hear in that first reading that Abraham was called by God, and he says, "Here I am." He responds to the call, and all of you have been responding to the call all throughout this year. Our faculty and staff responded immediately into the pandemic when we pivoted and went to online learning. I said they spent this summer gearing up for the hybrid model. They were all in. They said, "Here we are." When we were given the opportunity for a vaccine, they said, "Here we are. We're all in this." Just with all of you as well. We are all in this together. And so we follow that example of Abraham, who has said, "Here I am, Lord, you've chosen me. What is it you need me to do?" And we've answered that reply by the way in which we've lived our lives. But God challenges Abraham to give up the most precious thing that he has, and that is the gift of his son. And while Abraham is challenged to the very core and essence of his personhood, very much the same as we have all been challenged to the core of our very personhood by giving up our loved ones through to this pandemic, Abraham trusts in God, and God delivers. God delivers and frees his son from the burden of death. As we gather this day, we recognize that we may not receive the same blessing as Abraham, that our loved ones may have been taken from us, but God continues to choose us to remain in this world to bring forth life, faith, forgiveness, healing for each other. It will take us a long journey to get there, but that's why we have communion and community. The gift of community life enables us to take bold and faithful steps together and to recognize that we are not lost in our suffering, but that we are transformed in our faith together. And as we follow the example of God's presence in our lives, and as we follow the witness to God's call in our lives, we understand and see life differently. That brings us to Jesus with his disciples on the top of the mountain. Peter, James, and John, they're with him on the top of the mountain, and God reveals to them the very gift of his son, the gift of the one, the Messiah, the one who has come to free them, to liberate them, to call them to new life, to help them grow in faith. We know Peter's the one who's the denier. We know Peter's the one who's the doubter. We know Peter's the one who becomes the rock, because out of his understanding of his faith, he grows deeper in the understanding of the revelation of God's love in his midst and embraces that love for Christ and then promotes it in this world. James and John, along for the ride, their eyes are opened. They see life differently. They understand that this Christ has come into their midst. The Messiah is there. And they are asked then to follow him, to reveal him by their actions, and to learn from him. In the same way, so are we. We've gathered here this Sunday to come to the table of Christ, to see him revealed in the breaking of the bread and the sharing of the cup, to continue to embrace his message from this gospel and to allow it to transform our lives in relationship to each other, to allow our faith to grow, to allow us to grow deeper in the love of God, and to recognize that we are not abandoned, but that we are called God's beloved, God's children, God's disciples in this life. Paul's letter to the Romans once again reminds us that if God continues to be for us, who can be against us? It is the call to discipleship and faith. It is the call to witness. It is the call to life with God. May we continue to live that part of the journey for each other. May we continue to bring hope and healing into each other's lives. May we recognize that this pandemic is one moment of time, and may we take the long view and vision. Just as Christ gathered his Peter, James, and John on that mountaintop, may we go to the mountaintop and see the long vision of life with God and with each other. In this season of Lent, let's not lose our steps. Let's not lose our way. But let us be transfigured into the presence of Christ for one another. And so, my friends, I ask you, do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of our God?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And I do as well. This is the faith that we are proud to profess through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And so we gather this day and offer our prayers for our community of believers and for all of us gathered throughout this world. And so we pray. Loving God, we ask your prayers today for all of our sisters and brothers who have entrusted to your care, who have been part of our life's journey across this globe, suffering from this pandemic, and especially those 500,000 who have gone before us. Loving God, as you have welcomed them home, may the gift of your Spirit bring us comfort and hope and healing. May the presence of Christ continue to raise us up and strengthen our faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Today we pray in a very special way for the gift of faith as we journey forward in this season of Lent. May our journey into the love of Christ continue to take root within us, and may our vision be the greater vision of hope and healing in this world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our students here at De La Salle Institute as they prepare for the third quarter exams. We pray for their determination and their stick-to-itiveness, and for their courage. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us pray for the generosity of their instructors. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us pray as well for all of our friends and benefactors and all of those who support the LaSallian mission of education here at De La Salle Institute and throughout the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us pray for all of those in need of healing of body, mind, and spirit, for all of those in need of hope and healing of all of its forms, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And Lord, as we pray for all of those who've gone before us, we entrust into your care all of our loved ones and all of those of the LaSallian family. We pray to the Lord. Almighty God, you've heard our prayers as we stand before you this day, for through your goodness, we continue to see your presence revealed in our very lives. Strengthen us in faith, hope, and love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated as our altar is prepared. Sisters and brothers, that our gifts of bread and wine may be acceptable and pleasing to our God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church.
May this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, cleanse us from our faults and sanctify your faithful in body and mind for the celebration of these Paschal festivities. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after he had told the disciples of his coming death on the holy mountain, he manifested to them his glory, to show even by the testimony of the law and the prophets that the passion leads to the glory of the resurrection. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before you we proclaim without end the gift of life. Walk with us through the journey of our lives. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once for his disciples, and so now for us, he opens our eyes and opens us to the scriptures, reveals his very self in the breaking of the bread. Therefore, Almighty God, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify our gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread, sharing it with his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and again our God gave thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all, so that sin may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. So as we gather to celebrate the life, death, and resurrection of your Son, we offer you, Almighty God, this bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence, ministering to you and to each other. Humbly we pray that by partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And remember, Lord, your people and church gathered throughout this world. Help us grow together in faith, hope, love, freedom, and peace. May the leadership of Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, the world's religious leaders, your clergy, religious, and all of your people continue to call us into the gift of faith. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all of those who have suffered and we've lost from this pandemic. Welcome them all into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with all of the apostles and saints who have done your will throughout the ages, we pray that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in unity with the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Following the example of Jesus, our brother, let us call upon God's love and mercy for us as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grant us peace in our day, that by the help of your love and mercy we may be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And may we safely offer one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Thank you.
This is the Lamb of God that had opened the eyes of Peter, James, and John on that mountain of the Lord. This is the Lamb of God that enters our lives to strengthen our faith so that our eyes and our hearts may be open to God's presence in our midst. Happy are we who have been called into his company. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ lead and guide us toward everlasting life. Amen. Miss Ray, that was beautiful and beautifully said.
My pleasure.
Almighty God, we stand before you this day because through our sharing in this Eucharist, you continue to change our hearts, our lives, our minds. You continue to make us your very own. strengthened by the gift of this Eucharist, strengthened by the gift of your presence in our lives, strengthened by your word taking root in our lives. May we go forward to bring healing, God's healing spirit into this world. And may we continue to remember that we are loved by God and that we are loved by one another. May that gift of God's love and grace strengthen our actions towards each other in this life. Change our hearts, Lord, now and forever. Amen. My sisters and brothers, I want to thank you for joining with us today in prayer. Remember that we continue to pray for you. You continue to pray for us and our mission of education here at De La Salle. I want to thank you always for your continued support to our meteors and to their educational efforts. If you're looking to get involved with us, please check us out on the website at www.dls.org. We have a President's Day raffle that you want to take part of. I'm sorry, not a President's Day, a Founders Day raffle on May 14th. Raffle tickets can be purchased online, so we encourage you to do that as well. On the third Thursday of every month, Central Time, we have an alumni Zoom meeting, and we invite all of our alumni to participate and learn a little bit more about what our students are engaging in and to continue to network with each other. The other piece I would invite you to consider worth getting involved in is our Founders Day Gala. Our Great Futures Gala is what it's called, will be on May 14th. And there are sponsorship opportunities available with the gala, and there'll be much more talked about in the future. So these are just a few of the upcoming events we encourage you to participate in and continue to get involved in as part of the Meteor family. We wish you and your loved ones the very best of health, of body, mind, and spirit. May the gift of God's love and grace be with you. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our celebration is complete. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
St. John Baptist de La Salle,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Lourdes,
pray for us.
Live Jesus in our hearts.
Amen.